Masashi Kishimoto. We are so excited to see him today, aren't we, You know, it cannot be overstated just how important it's been to Masashi Kishimoto's work. Naruto has been to North American manga. It really opened the doors for a lot of things. So I actually want to introduce somebody. He's the president and CEO of Viz Media, the publishers of Naruto. And he wants to say a little bit about Naruto on the completion of the manga and, you know, a little bit about Kishimoto-sensei since he's here today, since you're all here today. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ken Sasaki.
How are you guys doing? Are you excited? Who is the biggest Naruto fan here? Who is the loudest Naruto fan? I think I have an advantage. I have a microphone, so I can be the loudest and the biggest fan. So, speaking of, you know, how popular Naruto is, do you know how many copies of Naruto manga have sold worldwide? So, it's about at least 220 million copies. So we have about 2,000 people in this room right now. So that means each of you has to carry 100,000 copies of Naruto on your lap. That's how many books of Naruto have been sold worldwide, over 40 countries. So, if you take each page of Naruto of that 220 million copies, put them all on the floor, that's gonna become 410 square miles, which is more than 12 Manhattan Islands. If you bring all those books, put them next to each other like you do on your bookshelf. How long does the bookshelf need to be? Who is from Austin, Texas? Okay. It goes all the way from New York to Austin, Texas. It's over 1,700 miles. By the way, this is the 72nd volume of the last volume of Naruto. And this is the Comic-Con special edition. The artwork, cover art, is specially drawn for this event by Kishimoto-sensei. So, person who said from Austin, Texas, come see me after that. This is going to be yours. I have so many more stats I can tell you, but I'm not the one you came to see, right? So I'm gonna give this back to Chris. And Chris is going to officially introduce Kishimoto-sensei you all have been waiting for. All right, enjoy the show and thanks for coming.
So, just so you know, that book that he held up, that's the special New York Comic Con edition of Naruto. I'm sure you've already got your copy because you're the biggest fans in the world, right? You already went to the Viz booth today, you got your copy. But if not, you can go to the Viz booth on the floor and pick up a copy. And I actually want to talk a little bit about, just a little bit about Weekly Shonen Jump. which is on the web, on iOS, on Comixology, where Naruto has been serialized ever since, you know, the beginning, the early, early times. If you, everyone who is here at Comic-Con, if you come by, if you go by the Viz booth, you can get a free 1 month subscription to Weekly Shonen Jump. And you're going to get the Weekly Shonen Jump yearbook if you sign up for it as well. The annual subscription is only $25 right now, too. So it's a really good deal if you want to keep reading stuff like next week if you sign up. Karakuri, the very first one shot of Kishimoto Sensei, is going to be distributed digitally on Shonen Jump next week. So you guys get it for free. All you need to do is go by the Viz booth, or maybe there's a little special thing at the end of this panel. We'll talk about that. Oh, and also, there's an app now for Naruto. You should check that out. I'm actually really enjoying it. Free chapters every day. You should read the Naruto. But I'm sure you've already read Naruto, which is why you're here to see Masashi Kishimoto. I don't know. That could be louder, I think. I think we all want to really welcome. It's his first time in America. It's first time in New York. First time at a North American Comic Con, which is like a whole thing. Can we make a lot of noise and please welcome to the stage Masashi Kishimoto? It's a good job, guys. Joining Kishimoto Sensei on the far left is Mr. Otsuki. He's actually the final editor of Naruto, and Mr. Kishimoto's editor. All right, so very, very first thing I want to say on behalf of myself and everyone in the room, congratulations for completing the manga of Naruto.
Chris, I think he wants to say a brief greeting to the fans.
Oh, that'd be wonderful. Please go ahead.
Nice to meet you. My name is Masashi Kishimoto. 今日はよろしくお願いします。
My name is Masashi Kishimoto. I am really, really, really pleased to meet you today.
Did you ever imagine that Naruto would go on for as long as it did? 72 volumes. It's an incredible accomplishment.
Actually, you know, I never imagined it. In fact, I actually thought it might get canned after the 10th week. That's actually a regular occurrence at Jump, that if the fan reaction is not very good, episode 10, the end.
Well, luckily we all got 72 volumes of Naruto. I gotta ask, actually, it's 72 volumes of Naruto. Did the editors of Shonen Jump want you to keep going? I mean, some of the Shonen Jump series go for 100 volumes or 200 volumes. Did the editors want you to keep going on Naruto?
しかし、72巻って言っても、まあある連載は100巻または200巻も続く連載もありますので、こっち亀と、あの、もしくは編集の方から、いや、もっと長く続けと言われたりされました。それはあの、上の上層部の方から圧力はありましたけど、僕はあの、なるべく自分でここまでっていうところは決めてやりました。
Well, I would be lying if I said that there wasn't some pressure from management, the powers that be, as they were. But, you know, I had a pretty clear idea of how I wanted the story to come to a close, and I kind of put my foot down and said, no, I'm sorry, this is it.
Mm. Now, I actually went back and found your very first English language interview in 2006 for Shonen Jump USA, And you said that you had the ending of Naruto perfectly visualized, the layout, the text, the scenes. And that was in 2006, this is almost 10 years later. Were you able to execute the ending exactly like you imagined it would be?
僕は実はあの先生の最初に英語、まあ、英訳されたインタビューを読んだんですけど、はい、それはもう2006年、もうほとんど10年前のことなんですけど、その時にもう先生が、いや、ナルトのエンディングはくっきり頭の中で決められてるとおっしゃってたんですけど、本当にそうだったんですか？
本当にそうでした。ナルトとサスケの最後の、和解のところ、倒れているところ、あと石像、初代柱間とマダラ の手がこう組むところはもう最初に絵で描いてありました。それをずっとノートに書いてて、しまってました。お願いします。
Actually, it really was all in my head. I actually had envisioned that Naruto and Sasuke would make the sign of reconciliation in the Valley of Endings by the statues of First Hokage, Hashirama, and Madara. That was, I actually had visualized all that.
Ah, that's so cool that you had that finished from the very beginning, and then you actually were able to manage to put it in at the very end, too. That's very, very cool. I know you've been working on some of the stuff like this Seventh Seal, or the Scarlet Hokage and the Seventh Seal. It's very nerve-wracking to be in front of you guys. You guys love Naruto so much. straight up, you've been working on a lot of stuff. The Boruto movie, the new manga, the side stories, the novels. It seems like, though, that you might be just winding down a little bit and taking a little bit better care of yourself. Is that true? Or is your workload still, you know, every day like it was with the weekly Shonen Jump?
まあ、あのシリーズが完結したにつれて、まあ、次のプロジェクト、例えばそのあのノベル、あの小説など、あと七代ホカゲのお話、あのもちろん劇場ボルトにも関わったと聞いてるんですけど、あの以前よりは、まあ、少しはあのお仕事が楽になって、ちょっと休養を取れることはできましたか？
そうですね、少し楽になりました、仕事は。ただその連載が終わってですぐあの映画の脚本をやらなきゃいけなかったので全くその辺は映画が作るまでは休めなかったです。ボルトの脚本は初めて映画で僕が全部書いたので、その時は休めてなかった。最近です、本当に最近休めるようになりました。子供と遊んでます。
So yeah, I would say that life got a little bit easier when I finished drawing the series. On the other handright, I mean, it might not be obvious to the fans who don't know the timeline, but literally as I was drawing the last chapter, I was told that I would be working on the screenplay for the new movie, Boruto. And it was the first time I actually managed to work on an entire screenplay by myself. Mm. But on the other hand, that came right after the series. So, you know, it's only very recently that I was truly able to start relaxing just a teeny bit and spending more time with my children. Mm. It was only after I finished the screenplay and the actual production on the movie started that I was able to start taking a break.
So I actually heard you got married while you were doing Naruto. Is that correct? Like you got married after you were sort of already drawing.
なんか連載中にご結婚なされたと聞いたんですけど、嘘ですか本当ですか？
本当です。
It's the truth.
But I heard you were actually so busy with Naruto, you were actually never able to go on honeymoon. Is that true?
でさらになんかあの連載で忙しかったため、あの新婚旅行にも行かれなかったと聞いたんですけど。
本当です。
That is also the truth.
So, I mean, this is your first trip to America. This is a honeymoon with all of your fans in America. How's that?
じゃあこのアメリカに来ること、ニューヨークに来ること自身が新婚旅行ではないのでしょうか？あの皆さんのファンと一緒の新婚旅行。
あの、なんでしょう。あのそれはね、あの子供に学校がありまして。あの連れてこれられなかったので、あの奥さんも子供と一緒にいるので残念ながら今回はダメだったんで、今度また来たいと思います、家族揃って。はい、お願いします。
You know, I would love to have said so, and nothing against you guys, but unfortunately there's something called school, and my children are, I have to go to school, and therefore my wife had to stay behind in Japan as well. So much as I love you all, it's not really a full out honeymoon. So, that just means I have to come back to America someday.
Now, in every good shonen story, there's the hero, but there's also the rival who pushes the hero to achieve great things. In manga production, it's very clear that your rival is Oda-sensei, creator of One Piece. Now, your series started within a few years of each other. You've battled it out as the most popular manga in Shonen Jump. How does Oda-sensei feel now that his rival has stopped making his rival manga series? Has he said anything to you about it?
もちろん、ナルトだけでも、ヒーローがあり、ヒーローのライバルがあるんですけど、漫画だけの、実際に、先生に対してライバルは、その小田先生と聞いてるんですけど、このナルトが完結されて、ライバルをなくして、小田先生からのコメントとかリアクションとかありましたでしょうか？はい。僕にとって、ライバルはワンピースの小田栄一郎先生なんですけど、 で、僕も一人勝手に言ってたんですけど、向こうも意外とライバルとして最後のコメントで認めてくれたっていうか、ライバルでためともっていうふうに最後のナルトの回で裏のコメントで書いてくれたので、とても嬉しかったのと、あとワンピースもナルトもずっと長い間やってるんで、いつ終わんのみたいなのは言われるんですけど、で、 2人で会った時に、いつこの漫画俺ら終わるんだろうねっていう話はしてて、それでワンピースがなかなか終わらないので、ナルトが終わったのを見て、あ、自分の漫画もいつか終わるんだっていうことに気づいたって言ってました。だから終われるっていうことを実感したって言ってました。お願いします。
So yes, indeed, I would say my rival is One Piece's creator, Eiichiro Oda. And honestly, it's interesting because I was just saying that on my own in the beginning. And then finally, in the back of volume 72, Oda-sensei acknowledged the fact that he considers me his rival as well. And that felt so gratifying. And of course, both One Piece and Naruto ran together for so long and ran even in Japan in Shonen Jump together that sometimes we'd meet up and be like, oh, you know, I wonder how long our mangas are gonna go on. And then, you know, of course, One Piece kept going and going. And so when I finally, you know, said, well, actually Naruto is gonna be concluding soon, it kind of gave him the awareness that, oh, I guess One Piece may have to, or may conclude sometime in the future too. It gave him awareness of an ending.
Oh. And I want to stress, Naruto has been an incredible success story in North America, in Japan, around the world. It's actually throughout its career not just been the best-selling manga, which it has been. It's not just been some of the best-selling comics. It's actually the best-selling comic series. It's actually been one of the best-selling books of all time on several weeks of release for the Naruto manga, outselling every other kind of fiction, nonfiction, everything. Naruto is a genuine phenomenon. And I guess, when did you first realize? Well, yeah, we can apply for that.
まあ、ナルトの大成功は、特に北米では、その漫画のジャンルだけでなく、コミックス全体の分野だけでもなく、もう本当、出版されてる書籍全体的にベストセラーでもあったんですよ。それについて、先生はいつ気づき、
どういうご感想か教えていただけますか？今知りました。びっくりです。I
actually just found that out. about the it being a top selling book, not just a comic or a manga. どう思われますか？もう信じられない。嬉しいです。 I'm really happy, but I'm still having trouble processing it.
Well, when did you first realize the effect that Naruto is having on fans around the world? Like, it's so popular, and it changed so many people's lives.
いつじゃあそのまあ日本のファンだけでなく世界中にもファンがいらっしゃって世界中のファンにナルトが影響を与えてるって知ったのはいつ頃ですか？
初代担当の八木さんっていう方がいるんですが一緒に立ち上げた担当さんがいてその担当さんがからあのファンレターを来たあの週刊少年ジャンプに届くファンレターがあるんですけどそれをいただいた時になんかあのいっぱいこう読めない僕日本語しかできないんで読めないあのいろんな国のファンレターが届くようになってあれこれもしかしてっていうふうに思ったのが最初です。
So actually, I guess I might have kind of started realizing it when my first editor, Mr. Yahagi-san, we have, you know, the Shueisha office and there's a specific department for Weekly Shonen Jump. Mm. And fan letters would be sent there. And he came by and would give me a bundle of letters every time he'd see me. Mm. And I started noticing that there were letters that I couldn't read. I'm Japanese and I only know Japanese. So any other language would look like, well, Greek to me. So, you know, and that's when I guess started realizing that, wow, there are fans that don't live just in Japan.
Mm, that's super cool. Do you ever feel like anything has surprised you about the fan reaction from international fans to Naruto?
ではその海外のファンへ、あの、ナルトへの反応にびっくりされたこととかありますか？
そうですね。その、とにかくその最近にこう iPad とかであのいろんな映像が見れるようになってそのコスプレの方とかあのを目にするようになってそれでちょっとびっくりしました、はい、あと自分でそのさっき言ったあのファンレターをあのどうにか解読しようと思ったんですけどあの全然できなくて、いいファンレターだって勝手に自分で思い込んでるんですけど、あの、何でしょう。とにかくそういうもあの手紙とかあとコスプレの方とかそういう映像とかその文字の媒体とかで見てあの実感しましたね。はい。
I would say I think I really started becoming more aware of it. I don't know about surprise, but definitely you know it started sinking in when more recently.With the iPad, I've been able to look at images or watch videos of cosplayers from all over the world. And that made me realize, you know, how much passion, just how much you love Naruto, but how much passion you can express with my work. And in fact, there was one time that it was thinking about trying to make heads or tails of all the, of all the foreign fan letters I received. Andyou know, I kind of gave up on that, but I wanted to think that they were all positive. But, you know, especially seeing all the images of all the cosplayers out there made me truly realize what a global impact the work has had.
あともう一つ、もうまさに今がそれです。今、皆さんを見てそう思いました。今です。
And actually, that's something that just came to me as I look out upon all of you.
Can it...Cosplay has always been such a big part of the Naruto phenomenon. Everyone's got headbands on today. Everyone, hands up and scream if you got a headband on. And I love the character designs in Naruto. They're so good and they're always fresh and you keep redesigning the characters as they get older as well. Did you ever think about the cosplayability of the character designs? Because people love to play cosplay Naruto more than maybe any other series. And did you think about that when you were designing it, that people would be wearing the character designs that you had created?
まあ僕はいつもあのナルトを読んで、ナルトのキャラクターデザインがすごく優れてると思ってたんですけど、あのもちろんそのあのナルトの人気が人気になってから、その本当にアメリカまああの海外のコスプレイヤーもすごく増えたんですね。特にナルトのコスプレイヤーが増えたんですけど。先生はもともとからその、まあ、コスプレしやすいキャラクターデザインとか認識しながら意識しながら描いたんですか？
いやそれはね全く考えてなかったです。なのであのコスプレしにくいのもいっぱいあると思うんですけど、もう皆さんだからコスプレイヤーの方はすごく大変だなってちょっと反省してます。特にこことか皆さん蒸れてませんか？大丈夫ですか？
え？あ、蒸れて
ませんか？っていうお願いします。
Actually, not at all. In fact, I actually feel like a lot of my characters might not be so easy to cosplay. And in fact, you know, to all of you out there who raised your hand saying you had headbands on, I feel really bad and I kind of feel remorse because, I mean, are you sure you don't have like a rash that it's not rubbing, like kind of rubbing against it and chafing at all?
You guys are all right though with the headband? Oh, they're okay. I know, now I want to actually talk about a little bit more about the manga. I know you greatly admire the work of mangaka Katsuhiro Otomo, creator of Akira, which is awesome, by the way, and Domu, and Akira Toriyama, creator of Dragon Ball. Yeah, it's a Shonen Jump audience. Love it. But I wonder if there's any other manga you're fond of. I know you really, I've heard about maybe Sonora-sensei or Matsumoto-sensei. Any mangaka that you really like? Manga that you really like?
昨日でもそうですし、以前にも、あの、北野は、まあ、大友先生のアキラ、それから、まあ、鳥山先生のドラゴンボールとかに強く影響されてお好きだと聞いたんですけど、他の漫画家、例えば、まあ、あの、松本太陽なり、あの、先生なり、サムラ先生なり、以外の漫画家、または漫画作品がお好き、または影響されたものってありますか？はい、手塚治虫先生の火の鳥の方編とか、 ですね。あと、井上武彦先生のスラムダンクとか、あと、あの、浦沢直樹先生のモンスターとか、20世紀少年、そういうのが好きです。影響を受けました。I
have to say that I've also over the years enjoyed and also perhaps influenced by Osamu Tezuka Sensei's Phoenix, especially the Karma arc. And then I would say Takahiko Inoue's Slam Dunk. And finally, I mean, there's so many, but if I had to narrow it down, another person I would mention is Naoki Urasawa's Monster, as well as the 20th Century Boys.
Ah, all very good series. one of my favorite parts of the manga is, especially in the early volumes, the notes you would do to reader. To the readers about sort of your life and about breaking into the manga industry. I think a lot of people found them very inspirational that you really worked and tried and finally sort of made it in. And I actually, you know, I want to, the thing is though, I mean, you tried a lot of different manga and a lot of different age groups and things like that, but ultimately I felt like maybe Jump was the most important to you. Was it really important to make a Jump manga to be a Jump mangaka?
で、まあ、あの、ナルトの、まあ、あの、単行本で最初、あの、1話1話の間に、あの、作者コメントの欄がありますけど、そこでよくなんか、いろいろ書いてらして、まあ、本当に先生の熱心、あの、漫画制作に関しての熱心とか感じたんですけど、その、あの、ナルトより前も、以前も、なんかいろんなジャンルとか、いろんなテーマの漫画に、あの、挑戦されたとか聞いてるんですけど、あの、先生にやっぱり一番、やっぱり、あの、
念願に思ってたのがジャンプだったんですか？そうです。ジャンプだけです。あの、僕がジャンプ黄金期、あの、ドラゴンボール、北斗の拳、セイントセイヤ、そのあたり読んで、あの、育ったので、あの、リアルタイムでずっとジャンプを読んで育ったので、あの、もう、憧れはもうそこにしかなくて、もうジャンプ以外は考えられなかったです。
Yeah, I have to say that no matter what projects, what stories I came up with in the end, my dream was always to be part of or succeed in Shonen Jump. And I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that when I grew up, I was reading Shonen Jump, weekly Shonen Jump during its golden age. And this includes series like Dragon Ball, Fist of the North Star, Saint Seiya. I read these in real time, week by week, when I was growing up. And I think that's why, you know, it was always kind of like this, you know, sometimes far off, but always a goal that I wanted to achieve.
Thank you. Now, Now, that era of jump that you're talking about is largely considered to be the sort of golden age, the golden era of jump. I read an interview between you and Oda-sensei where you both said you were both lucky to have read jump during that time. But, I mean, for fans today, especially in North America, that manga wasn't available. And so when Shonen Jump started here in North America, a little bit less than 15 years ago, it included Dragon Ball for the first time, serialized, Dragon Ball Z. It included yourself, it included Oda-sensei's One Piece, it included Kuro-sensei's Bleach. Lots of long-running series that changed the face of comics, of manga in North America. And I guess I think that maybe that era of Jump, your era of Jump, could be considered a new golden age. What do you think? What do you guys think?
まあ、以前小田先生との対談でも、小田先生もそうおっしゃってたんですね。やっぱりその黄金の時代に、彼もジャンプを読んで育ったって。だけど残念ながらアメリカではまだそういう作品とかがまだ渡ってきてなかった時代なんです。で、そのアメリカでの英語版の少年ジャンプ、まあ月刊だったんですけど、リリースされた時、まあまだ15年も行ってないんですけど、 もちろん先生のナルト以外にもドラゴンボール、ワンピース、ブリーチとか、全部連載で初めてアメリカで、現れたんですけど、僕、多分ファンにとってはその時代、2003年あたりからがアメリカのジャンプの黄金の時代と思われたと思いますけど、先生はどう思われますか？それだったら、ちょっとおこがましいんですけど、
先輩方の前では言えないんですけど、ここには先輩方いないので、今が黄金期だと思います。You
know, it rings very, very happily, reverberates really happily within me. Even though I'm kind of embarrassed because I'd feel ashamed to say this in front of my mentors, the people that I consider the gods that came before me. Then again, they're not here, so maybe I can say it. But yeah, maybe it would be great to call it that the golden age here for Jump.
Yeah. Now, as a special treat for everybody, Kishimoto-sensei has agreed to maybe draw for us, and we're going to show it up on the screens. Do you guys want to see Kishimoto-sensei draw? Is that what you want? Are you ready to do that? Ah. All right. So.
これは下書きです。どうぞ。どっちでも大丈夫です。これ。これはペンのためしためにあの、なんか画面はなんかもう。So
what are you going to draw for us today?
I'm gonna do my best. Sensei, what are you drawing? What?
Guys,
you know,
calm down.
I kind of thought about other things, but I guess I'd at least have to start with Naruto. All right.
Now, while Kishimoto-sensei is drawing here, I'm gonna put Otsuki-sensei on the spot because he has to answer some questions now. Otsuki-sensei, what do you think makes a hit manga? Because Naruto is a hit, right, everybody? There you go.
ヒット作品の秘密、方式を教えていただけますか？キャラクターが魅力的であることかなと、どんな作品がヒットするか分かれば、僕らいらないというか、僕らの仕事もだいぶ楽なんですけれど、とにかくキャラクターが魅力的であることかなと思います。
Well, I guess, certainly an important thing is to have very appealing and attractive characters. Mm. But if we really knew the secrets of making hit manga, you wouldn't need us. And, I might not have a job. but it might not necessarily be a bad thing that we don't truly know. In fact, if anyone of you know, please let us know.
and this is for both of you guys. In the last chapter of Naruto, we fast forward to 15 years later, Naruto is a dad now, he's got a son, Boruto, and he's gonna go on adventures. We're gonna talk a little bit about that. There's maybe a movie screening tomorrow, or Saturday morning. You guys are all going to the movie screening, right? But the thing about the movie is, I mean, we saw the trailer, and it's crazy. Like, there's skyscrapers in Naruto now, and like computers and stuff like that. And one of the things that I thought about the series is that because it ended on such a peaceful note, it ended on the sort of end of fighting, was that is all that stuff that happened, that great technological advancement, because we've had peace for so many years. Do you think peace brings about prosperity in that way?
Well, that is interesting. Oh. 一応その、あの、最終話、第7話で、まあ、あの、結構、あの、未来へタイムスリップして、まあ、ナウトがお父さんになり、息子がいて、で、突然なんか背景に高層ビルとか、なんかコンピューターとか、なんかいろいろなんか以前なんか世界に存在しなかったものが突然現れたんですけど、それってやっぱりあの平和な世界になったからでしょうか？
まあ、そうですね。
そうです。
Yes, indeed.
Oh, very good. Thank you. I'm actually curious because you came in towards the end of Naruto as the editor on the project. Was it intimidating to take over such a beloved series as editor?
まああの大月さんは、はい、あの Naruto 途中からそれも後半、
はい、
もうほとんどあの最あの完結近い時点で Naruto のお仕事を始めたと聞いてるんですけど。ちょっとなんかやっぱり、恐れを感じたというか、
はい
まあ、こんなに人気な作品でファンがこれだけ、大好きな作品に関わりになんか怖かったっていうことはありましたか？
あの最初にその担当票っていうのをいただくんですけれど間違ってると思いましたね。やっぱりあ嘘だって思いました。でもまあよく見ると本当だったので、まあ、とてもびっくりしました。
I have to say that when, you know, we actually have it at Shonen Jump at Shueisha, a list of what series will be edited by which editors. And when I first saw the list with my name on it, I couldn't believe it. I thought it was either a typo or maybe like an April Fool's joke. and then, you know, I looked at it again, and I was like, that's actually my name, and it's actually on the same line as Naruto.
僕も小学生の頃から見てた作品だったので。
Especially since this was a title that I had seen... that I had watched and read as a kid too.
That's awesome. Thank you so much. Do you want to I mean, I don't want to pressure you. Do you want to do one more?
プレッシャーかけたくないんですけど、もう一枚書いていただけますか？
All right. Everyone scream their favorite character at the top of their lungs. I think I heard. Wait. Okay. Calm down. Actually, other than Naruto, who's your favorite character in this series?
だけど先生自身はナルト以外でしたら誰が次にお好きですか？
そうですね。なるべく簡単に描けるやつがいいんですけど、なんだろう。マダラ？
あ、多分あのトビとして面をかける
ジライア。じゃあジライア書きます。
Then why not go with ジライア？
That's a good. I mean, personally, I'm a fan Rock Lee, but yeah, the Jiraiya is.
クリスさんはロックリーは個人的に好きらしいんですか？
ロックリー。
Maybe I should do Rock Lee instead.
No, try.
いやいや、ジライアでいいです、ジライアでいいです。
The fans will turn on me.
don't watch me right now, please.
All right.
Just need to get a little reference.
Another question for Otsuki while we're waiting. Everyone Googles reference. all right, Otsuki-sensei, and Naruto has a very, very unique take on shonen manga. In that series, even the worst character, no matter how bad they are, how evil they are, they get redeemed in some way. They're sympathetic, they're understandable. And in some shonen manga, some characters are just like bad to the bone and then they die. But everyone in Naruto gets redeemed in some way. I'm really curious about where that comes from. I mean, what you think about that?
まあ、ナルトのシステムも結構ユニークなのは、悪役でさえも結局、反省して、やり直しするキャラクター、いいキャラクター、悪そのまま役役で残ってても、なんかちょっといいとこが出てくるキャラクターとか多いんですけど、それって、どこからそういうアイデアとかが来たんですか?
あの、悪役のキャラクター造形として、僕は答えることなのかっていうのはちょっと微妙なところではあると思うんですけれど、やっぱりそのキャラクターがそのお話の都合で動いてるわけではなくて、やっぱりそれぞれ岸本先生がキャラクター一人一人の生い立ちであったり、彼はこういう生い立ちだから、こういう、で、こうなって、こういう考えに至ったということを全てしっかり考えられているからだと。 思います。まあ、そうすると、やっぱりあの彼がこうなった、こういうことをするのにも絶対に理由があると、キャラクターそれぞれに、バックボーンをちゃんと持たせてキャラクターを作っておられるからだと思います。
I think the reason why it's different and where that comes from, of course, it's kind of weird for me to answer it because it all comes from him. And, you know, I think it's because these characters aren't just influenced by the story or do whatever they do in the story because of the story, but because when each character first appears, or even before that, Sensei has very carefully laid out how he wants the character to be, what his personality traits are, what has he done, what is he about to do, and a complete his personal history and background on each and every character, whether they be good characters or evil characters or villains. And so by understanding the character for who he is, to make the character he or she a complete, well-rounded character, I think is why they do become relatable. Because they're not just flat images on paper.
I think we've seen here from all the shouting, everyone's got their own favorite character in Naruto. There's so many different characters. And I feel like it's really easy to find somebody in the story that you really relate to. Otsuki-san, who do you relate to in the series?
じゃあ、大月さんはどのキャラクターを一番共感されますか?
共感? サスケ
I guess Sasuke?
Oh.
And you, Chris?
Rock Lee. He tries so hard. It's so inspiring. All right, so I gotta do a thing first, because I know the last volume's only been out for a week or two. Can I just get I was gonna say show of hands, but you guys can scream. Who hasn't read the last volume of Naruto? Because I don't want to spoil it if there's a lot of people.
72巻はまだ読んでない人手を挙げてください.
There are not enough of you. I am definitely going to spoil this. You guys ready? All right.
ネタバレになって申し訳ないんですけど.
No, I'll be good. I'll be good. So Sasuke keeps winning the character pulls for most popular character in Naruto. And Naruto's the hero, right? I always find it fascinating because Sasuke's got this pessimistic worldview. He thinks everything is going to fall apart unless he specifically holds it together. And Naruto's like, no, it's all going to work out. It's going to be great. And yet everyone's still like, no, Sasuke's got it. Sasuke knows what it's all about. I'm curious because I think that's a pessimistic worldview. And I think Naruto's worldview is very optimistic. What do you think? In the end, Naruto maybe defeats Sasuke's worldview and brings Sasuke around. So do you think ultimately that by liking Sasuke, you're more of a pessimistic person or a more optimistic person? Actually, I'm going to change it a little bit. I don't want him to think that say he's pessimistic. I'm going to say, do you think it's easier for everybody to relate to a pessimistic character? How about that? That way he's off the spot a little bit.
関してもやっぱり明るい方がいいと思うんですけど、なぜかやっぱりその人気投票ではサスケ一番人気である、もう繰り返しサスケの方がナルトより一番になってるんですけど、それってやっぱり一般の人、ごく普通の人はやっぱりその悲観主義の方に共感しやすいからだと思いますか？
まあ単純にあいつがの見た目が、サスケの見た目がかっこいいというのもあると思うんですけれど、そうですね、やっぱりそのでもキャラクターそれぞれ映し鏡というかいろんな考え方があるので、ただまあ悲しいより、まあ、悲しいことはまあ世の中実際には多いと思うんですけれど、やっぱあのフィクションの中ではまあ楽観主義なキャラクターが勝つというのはすごくいいことだと思います。
Well, I think some of it might just be even simpler than that, and the fact that Sasuke looks cooler and is kind of cooler,
yeah,
you know, even in terms of his abilities. But you know, whether it's Sasuke or Naruto, optimistic or pessimistic, and you know, there's everything in between as well. They're all reflections of some personality that exists out in the real world. And of course, you know, in fiction is not reality. And in reality, there's not always a happy ending. But because this is fiction, I guess that's why we end up focusing more or concentrating, highlighting more the optimistic worldview.
The jump worldview of you can do it.
Yeah.
That's a very thoughtful answer. Thank you very much, Otsuki-san. So we've got time for a couple more questions, and I'm just gonna do. Oh, sorry.
Do you want to answer a question?
Why don't we have
an
answer or something about the drawing? じゃあ先生、この2枚の色紙に描かれた、まあ、ジライアと、
はい、
あのジライア先生とナルトですけど、あのなんか絵に関してなんかコメントとかありますか？
そうですね、ナルトはあの久しぶりに描いたんで、あの久しぶりによっていう感じ、久しぶりっていう感じでした。でジライアはあの正直あんま覚えてなくてネットで調べたんですけど、ここ繋がらないから、あそこにあのジライアのコスプレされてる方を参考にしました。
So actually, it's the first time in a while that I actually drew Naruto or any character from Naruto. So I did have a little bit of nostalgia, but also I have to embarrassingly admit, I don't quite remember how to draw Jiraiya. And I tried to look it up, but I couldn't connect to the Wi-Fi.So, in fact, I used the Jiraiya cosplayer in the audience as my model.
Thank you. Thank you very much. 助かりました。
So, thank you, Jiraiya cosplayer. You saved me one.
Now, as you all know, coming up this Saturday, it's the Boruto movie, Naruto the movie, at the Hammerstein Ballroom. When the initial trailer was released for the Boruto movie, it had the line from you, "This is the pinnacle of my career, is the Boruto movie." So I would love to hear from you why you think that this movie that we're all going to go see on Saturday is the absolute pinnacle of your career.
まあ、あの土曜日に、あさってにニューヨークでもあの上映されるんですけど、はい、このボルトの映画に関してインタビューでは、このボルトがご自身のキャリア の頂点の作品だとおっしゃってたんですけど、それはなぜですか？
正直に言えば、その脚本を全部僕が初めて書いたので、はっきり言えば僕が漫画で書きたかった部分なんですよね。そこをあのアニメにしてもらったっていうのがあるので、なので僕の中では本当に最後の最後のナルトの最後の物語と思っています。なのでそこが最後のクライマックスと思って、あのこれ以上は描けない最高傑作って言いました。
So honestly, as I briefly mentioned before, this was the first time I'd actually been able to work on a screenplayFrom beginning to end. It's not the first Naruto screenplay I've done, but certainly the one that I personally wrote the entire screenplay. And, you know, the story is essentially something that I wanted to draw as a manga, but didn't have the opportunity to. So I was really able to make it, the story and the characters and everything, what I wanted to see done, and then have had the honor to have the anime come to life. Mm. But on the other hand, it's also something that I envision as this is the last chapter of Naruto.
Oh.
The last climax scene, etc.
Oh my goodness. Well,
I
think we should watch the trailer for Boruto. Do you guys want to watch the... Yeah. Let's watch the trailer for Boruto. Tech people, we're doing it. We're watching the trailer for... How you doing? It's a good-looking audience right here. All right. There we go.
この浜のところに日は燃える。日の影は里を照らし、またこの葉芽吹く。
影分身の術！
お前がナルトの息子か。
弟子にしてくれ！俺は父ちゃんを倒してんだ！
バカボルト、火影になるのは私よ！
俺は火影になりたくもねえ。こんな親なら初めからいねえ方がいいよ。
サスケ、あいつを頼む。
雨だって風だって、
もっと効率いいやつとかねえのかよ。
ナルトならできたぞ。
どうして俺のこと気にかけてくれんの。
お前はナルトよりうすらトンカチだ。それによ
くやったな。父親としてお前の成長を見守っていけるからだ。
クソ親父。いつだって
今だって我らより逃げおせると思うなよ。
時代は変わっても忍びの本質は変わらねえのかな。
俺はそう信じてる。
ここまでするには一体どれだけの。
お前は俺の弟子で
俺の息子だろ。
行けボルト。
見てろよ。
ボルト、ナルトザムービー。
負ける気がしねえ。
すごい。嬉しい。嬉しいです。こんな喜んでいただいて。
はい。I'm about to cry tears of joy too.
Kishimoto sensei, is there anything you'd like to say to the audience? Just one last remark.
あの、皆さんファン、あの、集まったファン、集まれなかったファンにも何か一言お願いできますか？
そうですね。ここまだまだこう会場に来れなかった方っていうのもいるっていうのも聞いたんで、それほどこうナルト、僕がただその日本であの縁側で普通に落書きとして書いたナルトがここまであのみんなにあの認めてもらえるっていうか知ってもらえて喜んでもらえるっていうのは本当に感無量です。あの全てのファンの方にも感謝っていうかありがとうの言葉しか伝えることはできません。お願いします。
So, you know, I heard that there are many fans that couldn't even make it today. And to hear that, after seeing how many people are already here, you know, this is just a little title that I started working on so many years ago without ever thinking about any impact that it might have, much less globally. All I could say is to know how many of you, how many fans love my work and have followed my work. I'm just so grateful. The only thing I really can think of saying is thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Masashi Kishimoto-sensei.
Thank you very much.